Hey everyone, CyVenom here with AWS. Now, if you've seen my videos before, you'll know Kubernetes is a great way to run containers at scale. But a lot of you might be wondering when to take advantage of a managed Kubernetes service from a cloud service provider. Of course, today we're going to be talking about EKS, Elastic Kubernetes Service from AWS. We're going to be diving right in, so if you do need a refresher on Kubernetes, be sure to check out my Why Kubernetes video. All right, let's dive right in. With a managed service, what cloud service providers are doing is managing some of the undifferentiated heavy lift for you. This isn't special work, it's just work that needs to be done in order to maintain a highly available and secure, scalable environment. Now, EKS is no exception to that. EKS manages one pretty vital piece of the Kubernetes architecture for you. That's going to be the control plane. So I'll sketch that out over here. Now, today we're going to keep it simple. We're just going to call it control plane, but just know that this includes a number of components, kube components, etcd, the API server. Essentially, it's handling communication between you as an operator, the cloud service provider itself, AWS, as well as the data plane or worker nodes, which is where your containers actually live, which we haven't sketched out just yet. Now, the critical piece about the control plane is that it's running in an AWS VPC, not a customer-controlled VPC. So AWS is going to handle things like the backups and the scaling and the patching and the upgrades of this environment. And so as your workloads scale up, this is going to scale up to handle that as well. So this is a piece that you really don't need to worry about. It's that undifferentiated heavy lift, and AWS will really manage this piece for you. So the control plane is going to be able to communicate with the data plane. And this is kind of the critical piece that as a customer you need to be focused on. And this is going to be running in your VPC. And essentially what this means is that you'll need to spin up some compute, and then you'll have more control and access over that environment. So let's talk about that. Let's talk about the compute, because before we have that, we can't actually run any containers. We can have a control plane, but it won't know where to run the pods, the containers themselves. So looking at your VPC, let's say we decide to spin up some nodes. Now, there's a couple of ways to approach this. I'm going to start with the way that's a little bit more complex. That's going to be self-managed nodes. So let's say we're spinning up some EC2 nodes here. And there's a number of considerations I'll need to take into mind here. Things like the AMI, the Amazon Machine Image, essentially, the operating system and some components that let it work with EKS. I'll need to register these nodes with the control plane, give it the right permission so it has access to access the workloads running within the cluster, within our VPC. In addition, we're going to need to do things like patching and upgrades and scaling. So you can imagine there's a lot of automation that I'll need to build here. But luckily, there's an easier way to do this. It's called managed node groups. So EKS has basically extended their API and has now given you a way to manage and spin up. Essentially, it's a provisioning and lifecycle management of the compute, the EC2 nodes, and you can streamline them with single API commands and operations. So for example, creating the node group itself, scaling it up and down. Another one that I want to mention here is that it comes automatically with a EC2 auto scaling group. Now, of course, we won't run the security patches and upgrades for you, but we'll give you a streamlined way, a single API call that you can simply call to make that upgrade go through. And this can really streamline some of that operational overhead of maintaining the individual nodes. Now, I should mention here that when running in AWS public cloud with EKS, you can go with EC2 or Fargate. Fargate is the serverless approach to the compute for customers that don't want the operational complexity of managing individual nodes, even in managed node groups. Fargate can give you that serverless approach. Of course, there are servers. AWS just manages them for you, giving you the right size compute for your workloads, reducing some of that operational complexity. Now, of course, for EKS running in hybrid environments, let's say on premises or on the edge, you can take advantage of EKS on outposts or EKS anywhere. Check out my video where I talk about those two in a little bit more depth. Okay, so we've laid out the control plane, the data plane, the worker nodes, and now we have a way to be able to execute commands against the cluster. I can use something like kubectl to run commands and deploy pods and containers, the standard Kubernetes environment. One thing I should mention here is that EKS is certified Kubernetes Conformant. Essentially, it means that as we're using an upstream version of Kubernetes, we pass all the conformance tests, and long story short, whether you're running Kubernetes workloads on-premises or in another environment, another cloud service provider, you can bring them to EKS with little to no code changes. I think that's some of the magic of using Kubernetes on top of AWS, this open source platform where there is a large community backing it. Okay, so how do we actually create something like this, right? How do we create these nodes, the compute, the control plane? Now, of course, one of the approaches, and this is something that many people start with when using a cloud service provider, is using the console. And this is a fine way to get started. Let's say we use the console to create the control plane itself. It's pretty easy to use the UI to do something like that. Now, let's say I want to do something a little bit more complex. Let's say I want to spin up the actual compute, the nodes, so I'll need to make some decisions like how many nodes, what type of nodes, that kind of thing. And so to do that, let's say I want to use a CLI. So use something called EKS CTL or EKS Cuddle, whatever you like to call it. Essentially, it is a CLI that AWS built for working with EKS specifically, as the name implies. So I could do something like creating a managed node group with that CLI tool. In fact, I could create the whole cluster with the CLI as well using a single command like EKS CTL create cluster. But there's one more approach I want to talk about. And of course, I'm not limited to these three, but I do want to focus on these. Terraform. And Terraform, I think, is a very popular way in the community to manage infrastructure as a whole. It's an open source infrastructure as code tool, and AWS is supported, especially EKS specifically. And one of the things that you can do here with Terraform is manage all of the kind of infrastructure components along with EKS as code. And this can be a very popular approach to kind of automating infrastructure, whether you're using GitOps or maybe something a little less full-blown. Terraform is a great way to kind of codify the architecture here. We've talked about some of the operational aspects here of how you can kind of deploy the control plane, the data plane. The last thing I want to touch on here is the fact that although EKS manages the control plane for you and even some of the operational lift with things like managed node groups, as customers are building containers and workloads on EKS, they realize they'll need to integrate with AWS in a number of different ways, whether it's load balancers or things like IAM, Identity and Access Management, Secrets Manager, integrating with the VPCs. So regardless of what specifically it might be, just know that there's a number of extensions, add-ons, and drivers that you can use with EKS. And I'll represent that kind of simply here and just say that you can integrate EKS with a number of AWS services. Now in the description, I'll give a little bit more information and pointers into what those add-ons and extensions are. So be sure to check that out. Last thing I'll mention here is that, like I said, EKS is certified Kubernetes conformant. You can take advantage of the number of open source third-party capabilities out there as well. One that I like to talk about is Carpenter. That's Carpenter with a K. It's a great open source project built by AWS that we contributed to the community that essentially enables you to better optimize additional nodes coming up in response to load. So it'll look for unschedulable pods. And I think it's interesting the ways it optimizes the infrastructure, especially when running on something like EC2. So be sure to check that out. I'll drop a link in the description below. All right, that's all I've got for today. Just to kind of quickly sum it up, with managed Kubernetes services like EKS, we talked about some of the different components with EKS specifically, but just know the idea here is that AWS is handling some of that undifferentiated heavy lift for you, allowing you to focus on what really matters, developing highly available, scalable containers, and really focusing on that kind of data plane aspect. Now, if you enjoyed this video or have any questions, be sure to drop a like and a comment below. Be sure to subscribe and stay tuned for more videos like this in the future. Thank you.